The Quran says, "Ma khalaqtul jinna wal insa illa liya'budun." I did not create the jinns and mankind except to worship me. No other purpose. The space people have been given is only for one purpose. They worship their Lord. But to worship their Lord, they need space. They need time. They need to eat and drink. They need to have family. They need all those things. So Allah has given them space. So Allah allowed you to eat and drink. Allah allowed you to make money. Allah allowed you to have income. Allah allowed you to marry because you need to have family. Allah allowed you to make friends and all those things because they help you. But that is not the purpose. The purpose of the space is only one, that you apply the circle there. Keep in that mind. When this happens really, what will happen? You cannot apply the circle in your space, in that line, straight line, unless you have patience. Why? Because the world is so attractive. When you eat, you like to enjoy. And then religion will come, no, hold yourself, be patient. You are not allowed to enjoy. You know, you have to control yourself. Don't eat as much you like. Don't eat whatever you like. When people have got the desire for the sex, they want to enjoy the life. Religion says, no, it is not, this is not the purpose. You have to worship your Lord. This has been given to you for a purpose. Understand the purpose. The only purpose for the sex or desire is that you get family. Marry who Allah commands you to marry. And then treat your wives and children as Allah wants you, not for enjoyment. Understand this thing very clearly, that basically in this world, believers are not meant to enjoy. If they are not meant to enjoy, they must learn how to be patient. If they are not patient, they will be annoyed. Because sometimes what happens is you are in the house, sometimes your wife does not listen to you. You become angry. You have to learn. You are not allowed to be angry. Think, you know, control your anger. Think really that I have to learn actually how to behave properly. Sometimes your children don't behave properly. You have to control your anger. Sometimes your friends don't behave. The world will not be run as you want. The world never can be run as you desire. Since it is not likely, since it is impossible that the world will be run as you want, you must learn how to be patient. You cannot change the world. You cannot make the space as you want. Space is given to you. Understand this properly. The space in which you are going to apply the religion, that space is not owned by you, not created by you, not made by you, it is given to you. Your father and mother, did you make them? Did you choose them? Allah made them. Allah chose them. The language that you speak, did you make it? Allah made for you. The place where you are born and where you grow, did you make that? Allah made it. The sun and moon, did you make it? Allah made it. Now in winter is coming. If you want to make the days longer and nights shorter, can you do that? You have to accept the, you know, reality as it is. If you feel too cold in this country, you can't change it. You can't say that, you know, I want in England all the year to be to be warm. You can't make like that. You can't make all the space you don't control. The space is given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What you need to control is the circle. Circle is yours. If you improve the circles, Allah will be happy with you. The space, you have to accept the space as it is. Since you need to accept the space as it is, you need to have sabr, patience. Because if you don't have patience, you'll be annoyed. Because you want certain things, you don't get it. You want when you come to your home, your wife receives you happy and smiling and nice with the food. But you come there, she's not happy. She has no food for you. What will you do? Being angry and, you know, breaking everything in the house and this and that? No, you are not allowed to do that. You have to be patient. She must have a reason for that. You know, your children come to your home and you think that they must listen to you, but they don't listen to you. Don't behave properly. Are you going to get rid of them? No, you have to learn your limits. You have to teach them, but you are not allowed to exceed the limits. Sabr. Basically, in this life, if you want to apply Islam, you cannot do without sabr. Is it clear? So shukr is your iman. Religion is start from the shukr. And then after that, when you apply the religion in your space, every single step you need sabr. Even the biggest king in the world, even the most powerful people in the world, they don't have what they want. Their life is limited. They can't extend their life. Their enjoyment is, you know, limited. Every single thing that you can see is limited. They can't make more than that. Problems come to them from where they cannot expect. Illness comes to them from where they cannot imagine. death will come to them from where they cannot expect. You cannot live this life without the sabr. It is such a true thing, really. Is it clear? So shukr is the foundation of your iman, and the sabr basically is the whole life. The whole life sabr. People say, how long I do sabr? Whole life. They know that many women complain that, you know, my husband does not treat me nicely. So when I said to them, do sabr, but they say, how long? Do whole life. Because that's the whole thing is, the whole life is for sabr. It's not for one day. The whole life. And then you become nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when somebody's husband is, you know, worse and worse, those women, they can become nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you don't take your husband's anger and not treating well as something bad for you. No, you can actually, you know, every single problem can be good chance for you, good opportunity for you to come near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understand this. But when you do sabr, you become near to him. He said, Inna Allah ma'as sabirin, Allah is with those who do sabr. So when your husband is not happy with you, Allah is with you. When you don't get the food that you want, Allah is with you. When you fast in the month of Ramadan and you do sabr, you can see everybody eating and drinking and you don't eat and drink, Allah is with you. When you go for the Fajr prayer and everybody around you sleeping, you do sabr, Allah is with you. What can be better than that? Allah's company all the time with you. Just imagine really. This religion is based on the sabr. You never can be Muslim unless you know how to be sabr. Is it clear? That why Hajj is there really. Hajj basically is a reminding of a history full of the stories of the sabr, patience. That basically is. What Hajj actually is. Hajj basically to train people how to do sabr. Hajj is to connect you with the history, which actually every step of that history is the sabr. The whole family of Ibrahim is sabr, patience. Hajj basically, that's why, you know, I always teach, Ibrahim is the imam of iman and imam of Islam. And Islam is based on the sabr. If you really want to be a good Muslim, you need to have to sabr. And if you want to learn sabr, you must connect yourself with Ibrahim. Ibrahim will teach you what sabr means. There nobody can do more sabr than Ibrahim. Ibrahim's family is known for sabr. His son Ismail, Quran says about him, Inna wajadnahu sabira. We found Ismail a sabir, patient. And even before Ibrahim, Ismail was born, Quran said to Ibrahim alayhi salam that, you know, we gave Ibrahim good news of Begulamin Halim. You know, a patient boy. Even before he was born, he was made patient. And then Quran, one of the verse in Surah Al-Anbiya, mentioned all the prophets, what the categories they are. And then Quran mentions Ismail and this prophet. And then Quran says, Kullu min as-sabirin. All of them are patient. Starting the whole story with Ismail. The whole family of Ibrahim actually the best example for the sabr. Is it clear? Walking on the path of Islam is impossible without the sabr. And sabr is impossible without learning it. And you only can learn the sabr when you connect yourself with Ibrahim. That's why you need to do Hajj. You go for Hajj, why? To do sabr, to learn sabr. If you go for Hajj to enjoy the life there, in the comfortable life and all those things, you get nothing. You get nothing. That's why you can see really, Allah has chosen the place for Ibrahim's family, the place which itself has sabr. Actually, the whole land is sabr. Even the animals of that land have sabr. The main animal of that land is what? Camel. Camel is the best animal for the sabr. Even a small child can carry it. Sabr. Don't get water for many, many days. Sabr, patient. The animal that is chosen for that land is example for the sabr. Camel is one of the best animal for the sabr. All the animals that you get, even the trees there, they have sabr. You can't get those trees which have no sabr, they can't grow there. The trees which have sabr, they can grow there. You can have the palm trees, you can get there. But those trees which have no sabr, they can't grow there. You need a sabr there. That's why the people who are there, sabr. So that's why the people who are chosen to be there, they only can be obedient to the Lord and the best people as long as they do sabr. If you take them out from there to a place which is different from their place, a place which has got palaces, houses, rivers, water, and all the luxuries of the life, then those people will be lost. Like fish, if you take out the fish from the water, lost. That way, Arabs, when they left that land, they lost. When they remained there, their best people. When they left that place, they lost. And when they remained that place, but the imported all the luxury from everywhere else, again they lost. Yeah. Arabs never can remain on the path of Ibrahim unless they choose to space to be as it was in his time. Understand this properly. It is, and I'm going to refer to the Quran, you can see properly. For a purpose, Allah has chosen that land. Ibrahim was not born there. Ibrahim was born in Iraq. He settled in Syria. And Syria is, you know, green land, you know, it is not like just desert. You can see all the Palestine, all those places like that. Why Allah chose this son of Ibrahim to be grown in Makkah al-Mukarramah where nothing is there? For a purpose. To bring, raise a tough nation. A nation which is full of the sabr. People full of sabr. If you take out from that land, that whole, you know, characteristics of that land, it will lost. So understand the thing, that land basically is to teach people how to do sabr, training people for the sabr, for the patience. So first thing, if you read the history, whenever Arab people, they left their land and they went anywhere else, they lost. They were not the same people. And in our time, when Arab people made effort to import everything else from everywhere to that land, they again lost. They are not again the same people. Because that land needs people who have sabr. That's why the Prophet said, nobody can do sabr on the difficulties of Medina life except the believers. Everybody will leave Medina. Now they cannot do sabr. They don't leave, but what they do, they import from everywhere. You can see again, they are not the same people. Ibrahim's people, they must remain like Ibrahim.